Yeah, that's right, Kendall. The Stillaguamish River right now at major flood stage. It could set a record today if the waters continue to rise. I want to show you this image, though, right here. The Jersey barriers here along this roadway literally holding the river back. You can see the river coming through the gaps in the Jersey barrier. Even down the road, we've seen a car that's been stalled out, abandoned there. Hopefully that driver was able to get out okay. But if you look over here along the Stillaguamish River, you can see pieces of debris that are floating down the river. We've seen massive trees actually being swept down. This one is, you know, just a little small stump compared to what we've seen so far today. But yeah, just a significant flooding event right here along the Stillaguamish. To the south of us in Granite Falls, there have also been reports of flooding and closed roads. Sheriff's officials had to rescue a driver in Granite Falls after they drove into standing water. Luckily, that driver was okay. There have been road closures and crashes due to the wet conditions popping up all over western Washington today. Along the Olympic Peninsula, the National Weather Service reported one rain gauge measuring more than 8.5 inches of rainfall in only 24 hours. This system is warm, with Seattle setting a record high temperature for December 5th, and the warm moisture is melting snow that's fallen in the mountains, with all that water running downslope into rivers and streams. Officials warning residents in low-lying areas that they should be ready to leave as the waters rise.
The time now to get together all of the important documents, so passports, birth certificates, marriage certificates, all of those things that are really difficult to replace, insurance documents. Gather those all together along with, you know, food and clothing that you might need to take with you in a hurry, and have that ready to go.
Now, today really isn't a great day to be out on the roads in western Washington either. We just drove up from Carnation up here to Arlington. It was about an hour drive along I-5, and it was rough out there. As we were passing semi-trucks, the spray can be very, very blinding at times. We saw water out there on the roadway, a lot of slowdowns due to water ponding on the roadways. And especially when it comes to conditions like this, where you have water flowing over the road, you don't necessarily know how deep that water is going to be. You know, it only takes about 12 inches of water to sweep away a small car. So really, you don't want to be driving through something like this. It can take only about 48 inches of water, or 24 to 48 inches of water to sweep away a large SUV or truck. So really, something that you don't want to mess with. So, you know, if there's water flowing over the roadway, you just don't want to go through it. But again, just a really rough travel day throughout western Washington today, and some significant flooding here along the Stillaguamish River.
I'm Amy Freeze. Welcome to Fox Weather's YouTube page. We have more great videos on the way, so make sure to subscribe to stay updated on all things weather.